The national, you're the new artistic director of the National Black Arts Festival.
That's right.
Meaning?
Yeah, National Black Arts Festival. It began in 1988. This is the fourth one. It's a biennial festival, which celebrates the culture of African Americans and people of African descent.
Where does it take place?
In Atlanta, Georgia.
When?
July 29 through August 7.
And what is it? Plays, dance, a whole?
Everything. Everything. Culture is everything, isn't it? So, I mean, there are eight disciplines, actually.
What?
Including music, dance, well, we can go on and on. We talk about health as well. But this is the only one of its kind in the world where you have this serious discussion of the presence of African people in the world. It's the only one that I'm aware of, unless somebody write in and tell me where there is another
right
one.
Now, do you get
700,000 people and upwards of the thing?
Do black writers and performers and dancers?
Everybody. Everybody.
And you're the director of all this?
I'm artistic director. So what I do, what?
What do you do?
I gather people.
I love the way you talk.
I gather people.
You know something? Avery, you could be the first man in history to do your own show, and you're your own guest.
Not
and
I.
No one else has to do it. Because you do this. You do.
No, I've been following you. It's fascinating.
No, I've been following you.
You know him. You know this. You say, then he has to gather. What? And then the answer is. And then why? And then I know.
You're talking to me.
But yes. That's right.
I gather. It is this gathering of people. It literally is.
What does the artistic director do?
That's exactly what I do. I gather, people. I gather them together and set it aloose. The culture speaks. What? It is at once an American festival. Yes?
Yes.
It's a wonderful thing. It's a wonderful
That's a
thing,
great,
but indeed, it is
and
this
obviously
gathering.
You can do it because you're not shooting in July and August.
Right? Yeah. Well, I am shooting in July at some point, but...
Are you going to give him time off?
Well, don't ask him.
Make him direct.
We'll discuss that later.
You're not going to give him time off to be artistic director of the Black Arts Festival?
No, I already am.
No, he'll get some time off.
Thank you, Rick.
Got it. Is he tough, really?
You've done it for me, see? You've said it in front of millions of people.
Well, now, you can keep going on with the show. There are other things you want to do. Can you dance at the same time? Could you go in and could you do a show?
I don't see how.
I mean, on
the dancing major. No, Major Kira does not know how to dance. Please.
No, you couldn't do it. Let's say you couldn't go into Sunset Boulevard.
No. Oh no. We work really long hours, and besides that, I have a 2-year-old. So between the two things,
how many episodes do you do a year?
What do we do? 26.
26.
We did 26.
So you're off for how long?
Until the second week in July, something like that.
Could you take a stock show out?
I mean, I would like to see what other work is out there, you know, television and film too. I don't know if I'd have time to do a show like that, you know.
The best thing, Renee, about a successful show is you're home, right?
Yeah, when you get home.
The work is steady. But no, but I mean, you can live in a place.
Yeah, to settle down.
It's not closing in Boston.
I must say I've been really blessed by this business here in this city. When I did Benson for 6 years, my kids were at an age where I was able to get up in the morning and make them breakfast and make them lunch and drive them to school and have a life, and now they're off in college. But
a television show is a hit based on its ratings, correct? How's it doing? How much money is it taking in, right?
Yeah.
A Broadway hit is a next day thing. Mm. What did the New York Times say?
That's right.
Totally different phenomena, isn't it?
Yes. And I've been the same place Nana has
you've
been, where
bombs
I've stood
and
there.
Hits.
Where you're at Sardi's at the opening night party, and you've stayed a little too long, and you realize the whole room is cleared out. And
here they come, and they're gone.
Yeah, and they're gone. Hey, there is, and everything's gone.
Do television critics affect the show, since it's a free medium?
To some degree, nowhere near to the degree that it does on Broadway or even in a motion picture.
Because I've noticed sometimes some shows are universally blasted, and they lead for the week.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Because it's my choice to watch it, and it doesn't cost me $40, right?
And some shows like Picket Fences are universally praised and
don't necessarily do well.
Yeah. Oh, we got good reviews. We've all
we got mixed reviews. We got very mixed reviews.
Next Generation got mixed.
When you started, but I think because we were like in your wake,
on
your
wake?
Apron strings, yeah. Or whatever they were more ready.
You work near each other?
Opposite.
Right across the alleyway.
We'll be back with our remaining moments, and we're going to let, in addition, in those remaining moments, we're going to let Michael Dorn fulfill a fantasy wish. Don't go away. I want to fulfill just a couple of quick things here. There's something that I wish the camera would just close in now on Michael Dorn, Lieutenant Worf. Because you don't even have to close in. Just make sure we record the sound of this, because he'd love to do something. Do it.
This is CNN.
Whoa. Not bad, huh?
Yeah.
When you go out on an audition and James Earl Jones is also there, do you go home? I mean, let's say it's an audition for a read over.
Actually, Rick has been threatening to recast Worf with James Earl Jones. He's been threatening that for 7 years. But no, James has been in quite a few more things than I have, and we're not up for the same things.
It's nice to say it, isn't it? This.
Oh. They always say that you know, you sound just like James Earl Jones. Yeah. Whenever I go for voiceovers, they down at the bottom says, we're looking for a James Earl Jones type, you know?
a type.
A poor man's James Earl.
But what happens after...
The world is larger.
Now, who's going to be in Voyager?
We don't know yet. We're putting together...
You're looking for a Jewish guy?
We're
in his early 60s. Kind of wants to change his lifestyle. So it's like, he could be like...
I don't know if you could take the hours. These people work from 5 in the morning until about 1 in the morning.
But there's got to be somewhere. Is there
somewhere? It is time for a Jewish guy in space.
And there's time for a talk show in space.
Talk show in space.
There's got to be a space talk show where the captain comes on. The commander comes on. Think about it, Rick. Think about it.
We'll work on it.
Oh. Yeah, forget it.
Yeah, I know. He just really don't hold your breath, Larry.
Don't tell him such
things. Keep the talk show
you
here.
You cannot joke about Star Trek. I mean, that's the other. Renee talked about it earlier. I mean, prepositions are important, you see. Yes, they are. So, I mean, on a certain level, we can ha-ha about it, but you really do have to call across the lot about it all. Right. Mm-hmm.
They do.
Why are you so serious about it?
I think you have to be serious about something that's potentially so silly. These are...
Yeah. Good answer.
These are people with funny makeup on their face flying around at speeds faster than the speed of light, running into other humanoid people who happen to speak English very well.
better than...
And we all take it very, very seriously. I think that's what's kept the show as clear.
There's a big difference between reality and truth. And what we are is true, and it doesn't matter whether it's fantastical, but the audience recognizes it as having a coming from a true place.
And the key to our series are these people, are the characters. Good science fiction on television has to be character-driven, and these people represent, with their colleagues, two families of explorers.
Thanks very much. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for being with us. Don't forget, you'll see the last episode next week, but they'll be rerunning them forever. And the movie's coming in Thanksgiving, and the Voyager comes next year. Have a great rest of the weekend. Good night.